Hi everyone, in this video we will cover what is cat and touch command. So first we will cover what is cat command, then we will cover what is touch command, and then we will try to execute this command on our Amazon Linux machine. So cat command is basically used to create file, to concatenate the contents to the existing file, then we can copy the content of one file into the another file, and also we have tag. So we'll execute these commands on our Amazon Linux machine. Before that, we will cover what is touch command. So touch command is used to create an empty file. We can create multiple empty files using touch command. Also, we can see the details like access time, modify time, and change time with the help of touch command. And with the help of touch, we can see three types of time. Like we have access time there, modify time, and change time. And suppose if we want to only update the access time, then we have to use touch-a. And if we want to update only the modify time, then we need to write touch-m. Now we will cover all these things practically on our Amazon Linux machine. Now here on AWS console, select EC2 and instances. So my instance is already in a running state, or you can launch the new instance using this option. Now I will connect to this instance and then we'll try to execute our commands there. So now here, first we will make one directory. To check this, we'll ls. Now here first I will try to create one file, so for that we will write cat file 1.txt. So using this command we are now creating file 1.txt, and now we can add the contents to this file. And we can save these contents using Ctrl D. So to check this, now we will only write cat file 1.txt. So suppose again if you want to edit this file, so for that we need to use vi or nano editor. But if you want to append or concatenate the contents to this file, for that we will write cat, and then this time we used double option. And now we can add the contents to this file. To again save this, we will press Ctrl D. Now to check this file, cat file 1.txt. So as you can see, it has concatenated the content to the existing file. Now suppose we want to copy the contents of file 1 into new file, file2.txt. For that we will write cat file1.txt file2.txt. So now this will copy all the contents of file 1 into the file 2. Again, suppose we want to check this, we will cat file 2 now, file2.txt. So as you can see, it has copied the content of file 1 into the file 2. And the last operation that we want to check is the tag. So for that, we will write tag file 1.txt. So as you can see, it will display the contents in the reverse order. So earlier we are having high line 1 and then line 2. Again check this. So cat is showing us the content in this order, high line 1, line 2, and tag will show the contents in the reverse order. Now we'll try to cover touch command. So for that, suppose we will first remove these files that we have already created. We have created file 1.txt and file 2.txt. To confirm this, you will ls. Now inside, suppose inside commands, now we are in commands folder, commands directory. So here we will create some empty files using touch command. So for that we will write touch and file name. So this will create the empty file. Now here, like cat, we didn't get the option to add the contents initially. Now suppose if we want to add the multiple files or to create the multiple empty files, for that we will write . So in this way we can create the multiple empty files using touch command. So file 1, file 2 and file 3 are created. Now if you want to check the statistic of this file, so for that we will write stat file1.txt. Now here you can see it has given us the access time, modify time and the change time. Now suppose if you only want to update the modify time of this file 1, so for that we need to write touch hyphen m and file name. So what it will do, it will pick the present time, like the current time, and it will mark that time as a modify time. Again, to check this, use stat stat file1.txt, and you can see the modify time and change time is same now. Similarly, if you want to update only the access time of this file, we will use touch hyphen a and file name. Now you can see the access time and the change time of this file is same. So in this way, using touch command, we can create the one empty file, multiple empty files, or we can update only the access time or only the modified time if you want.